Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Majitimer. I'm a product manager on the Azure Synapse Analytics team. I'm joined by Anshul Sharma, who's a program manager on the Azure Data Explorer team. And today, we're going to be talking about data sharing for ADX. Anshul is going to walk us through how you can share data with customers or partners using ADX followers securely and effectively. I'm going to hand it over to Anshul. Welcome.
Hi. I'm Anshul. I'm a product manager with the Azure Data Explorer team. Today, we are going to talk about data sharing with ADX. As you know, there are many traditional ways to share data, such as through file, FTPs, emails, and even APIs. These methods require both the parties, which is your providers, as well as consumers, to build and maintain a data pipeline that moves the data between teams and organizations. Now, with Azure Data Explorer, you can easily and securely share your data with people in your company or your external partners or customers, and the sharing occurs in near real time with no need to build or maintain this complex data pipelines. All database changes, including the schema and data on the provider side, are instantly available on the consumer side. Now, what are the use cases for data sharing? Typically, a data provider can use this integration to share the data with the customers in a simple and secure way. For example, a financial data provider can share the data in near real time with the customers without having them to maintain this data pipeline. As the data is updated on the leader cluster, which is the provider side, the changes will appear on the follower cluster, which is the consumer side, in few seconds or minutes. Now let's see some of these concepts and details. This is the documentation for the data share capability in ADX. We call this feature as follower databases. Now, follower databases allows you to attach your database located in a different cluster to your own ADX cluster. Now, these clusters can be in different subscriptions or even in different tenants. The follower database is attached in a read-only mode, making it possible to view the data and run queries on top of it. Now you can establish a leader and follower relationship via APIs, via SDKs, or even using ARM template. But you can also do that via Azure Data Share. Now Azure Data Share provides a UX to establish this follower database or follower leader relationship. And the way it works is we would see with the help of this diagram. As you can see on the left-hand side, there is a leader cluster which has three different databases, and you can read or write data into these databases individually. Behind the scene, the data is stored in the cold storage, which is the blob storage. Now, when you establish a follower relationship, in this example, you can see there is another follower cluster, which is the consumer cluster, and we have chosen to only follow database three from a leader cluster. What happens behind the scene is a symbolic link is established between the storage account of the leader cluster and the follower cluster. Now, what happens is all the data that is ingested in database 3 in the leader cluster would be available for querying in the follower cluster. A follower cluster can follow one or more leader cluster databases, and it will periodically synchronize to check for any changes. Now you can, the data on the consumer side, you can choose to cache because it has its own caching policies, and you can choose to have a different caching policies compared to the leader, allowing you complete flexibility on how you want to query the data. Now let's see all of this by setting up an example in action.
All right. Now we'll establish a leader and follower relationship between two ADX clusters, and what you're seeing on screen is the data share pane of Azure portal. So I have created a data share, and what we are going to do here is create a share which would include the details of the leader configuration that we want to share with a follower. So let's name it. And in the share type, remember to select in place. We are not replicating the data or creating a snapshot of the data. This is in place sharing. So once you select on in place, while adding the data set, you would see ADX as one of the source type. Now, at this point, you are asked to select the leader cluster through which you want to share specific artifacts. So I've already established a leader cluster, which is in my subscription. And what we are going to do is select the database in the leaders cluster, or you also have an option of sharing all the databases in this cluster. For this demo, I'm going to select a specific database. Now, there are a few other options that are available to us to establish granular sharing relationship. You can either share this entire database in a cluster, or you can choose to select specific tables, or you can also choose to provide specific wildcard patterns if you have in your table naming. And based on that, specific tables, materialized views would be shared from your leader cluster. So again, for this demo, instead of selecting specific table, I'm going to share the entire database. Now, once I do that, I'm asked to add this particular configuration as a data set. And the next step is really to provide the email address of your recipients or your consumers, which is tied to their Azure account. So at this point, again, I'm going to provide my own email, but remember, you can also establish cross subscription or cross tenant sharing, and basically you can provide multiple recipients here, and invitation to accept the share would be sent to them. So once I create or provide this email, I am creating and granting the permission for this data share. And what's happening behind the scene is a data set is being created, and this data share request email is being sent to all the consumers that you have provided. Now let's see how the experience looks like from the consumer side. Now, being a consumer, I have received this invitation to access the data, which has been shared with me by the provider. Now at this point, I can view this invitation and see. So here's the sample share, which we shared earlier. Now I have an option of mapping this to a specific data share account. Again, I'm going to use the same account which I use for creating the share for simplicity. And once I accept and configure this share, it would be available in the received shares. At this point, we have only accepted this, but we have not mapped the invitation to any of the ADX clusters. So let's do that. Now we'll configure this data set and map it to a cluster where we want to follow. Now clicking on this map to target, again, I have an option of selecting a cluster which would act as a follower in this case. And this is a separate cluster, as you can see, different from leader. So I'm choosing to map this specific database to this particular cluster, which would become a follower. So after a while, you can see the mapping is completed, and we have this new follower cluster, which is mapped to the data set which was shared by the leader. Now we are moving to the Web Explorer, which provides a query experience for ADX. And as you can see, this is the cluster, the leader cluster, through which we shared one of the database, which was F1, and which was mapped to another cluster, which will act as a follower. So if I expand this, you can see there's a nice little icon here, which indicates that this F1 database is not part of the this cluster, but rather relies on a leader cluster, and it has a symbolic link behind the scene. If I expand the database, you can see all the tables that are available in the leader cluster are also available in the follower. Now, just to prove that there is no data replication, rather any data that you ingest, any table that you create on the leader cluster should automatically be available for querying in the follower, what we would do is we would create this new table, which does not exist yet, which has two fields. And we will also ingest some data into this newly created table. So I'm ingesting a row just to count the number of rows right now. you can see there is one row that has been ingested in the leader cluster. And if I move to the follower cluster, you can see the table which we just created on the leader side is also available on the follower. And if I try to count the number of records, you can see it's completely in sync with the leader cluster. So as and when you would keep on adding or updating any data in your leader cluster, it would automatically be reflected in the follower cluster in near real time. So this is extremely important because there's no ETL, there's no transformation, there's no additional data pipelines that are behind the scene. Everything is happening seamlessly. Now, lastly, moving back to the portal side, just going on the follower cluster, this is the follower cluster which we had set up. If I go to the database pane, I can quickly see which of the databases belong to this cluster, or which of these are followers which belong or which are following specific clusters. So in this case, you can see cluster 2 and disk cluster. These are the two databases that belong to the same cluster, while F1 is the one that we set up as a follower cluster, and the relationship is shown as follows, and it also provides the link to the leader cluster, right? So this is extremely handy if you want to identify which of the databases are follower versus leader in your cluster. So that's all that we had for the demo, and thank you for joining.
Well, that wraps up our video for today. Thanks, Anshul. Tell us in the comments, who are you sharing your data with? I would love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan McJittimer. You can find me on Twitter. You can also find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter, AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.